Let's now turn our attention to the idea of hypothesis tests, an incredibly powerful technique in data analysis. Once again, let's look at the learning objectives and make sure we understand where we're going. We want to better understand the logic behind a hypothesis test for a population parameter. And we want to construct and interpret a test of hypothesis for a population parameter and identify appropriate parameters to test based on the data. And we also want to comprehend the types of statistical errors that can be made in the decision process for hypothesis tests. So we want to keep these in mind as we're working through all this. Now let's start off with just a very brief discussion of the logic behind hypothesis testing. And initially we're going to start off with univariate hypothesis testing, uni meaning one, where we will be dealing with only one variable. So univariate hypothesis testing is a technique that allows us to compare the value of an observed sample statistic with a believed population parameter. So in other words, we have what we believe is a population parameter, like the true mean, the true median, or true proportion. And we're going to compare a sample statistic with that value in such a way that will help us suggest that, you know, maybe we're wrong about that mean. It really is something else. Or that proportion really is something else. It's not what we used to think it was. It's that sort of a thing. So, suppose you believe a new treatment for a particular form of cancer will increase survival rate. Now, the current average survival rate is 2.25 years. I would use this, I would think about this as being the mean. This is what we believe the current survival rate based on the current treatment. Now, you take a test of 13 subjects and you find your average X bar is 3.1 years. Now, you don't have to have a degree in math to figure out that 3.1 is bigger than 2.5 or 2.25. It's kind of obvious, but does this mean your treatment is really statistically better? We have a situation here where this 3.1 years compared to 2.25, this is just based on one of a bunch of possible samples of 13. Remember the whole idea of a sampling distribution? Now, is this 3.1 such that it really suggests the average survival time is increased with your drug or your treatment? Or could it be a simple matter that if you went out and took another sample of 13, you could end up with 1.5 instead, which would be less than the current believed true average? So in other words, if I look at point three here, a univariate hypothesis test will give us a way to make that determination based on probabilities. Now, the technique will help us decide if the difference between the sample statistic here, 3.1 years, and the believed parameter value, 2.5, is simply by chance. Hence the idea, if it's by chance, it could be greater or it could be less than. Or if it is more likely real. If it's real, then it suggests that it really is bigger than 2.25. So your drug really does work better. Now, the basis for this decision will be how far 3.1 in this example is from 2.25. So just as a quick example, if the true mean we think is 2.25 and up here someplace is 3.1, what we want to know is this 3.1 close enough to 2.25 that it could be by chance, or is it more likely that the 3.1 really belongs to a distribution sitting up here with a different mean that is bigger than this 2.25? So who does this belong to, this distribution or this distribution? And the basis for it will be, remember the empirical rule, this is a general rule of thumb, and right now we're talking introduction here. We'll get into fine detail here shortly. But if this 3.1 is within two standard deviations of the believed mean, then as a general rule of thumb, we're thinking, oh, it's probably by chance. But if it's farther away, then we're thinking that shouldn't have happened. The probability of taking a sample and getting an average of 3.1, if it's like more than 2 centimeter divisions away, is very, very, very small. It shouldn't have happened, but it did. That would suggest that maybe it belongs to this distribution, not this distribution. That it's really a value from a distribution with a bigger mean, so the treatment is more likely real. The difference that we're seeing between these two is more likely real. So conceptually, that's what we're going to be doing. So now all we need to do is just work through the process to accomplish this.